It's the second series of the evening. We're on Apotheosis once more. And spawning to the bottom right-hand side in purple, playing for Psystorm, it's our Protoss player, Poizon. And to the top left in green, it's our reserve player, Wryza. A PvZ, which is actually going to be a quite interesting matchup on this map. I actually think that Zerg players don't really like that map in particular. I mean, there is the gold base, and there are some possibilities maybe to overrun a Protoss opponent, but there are also a lot of choke points where a Protoss army is difficult to get it surrounded. So, And then again, you also have a lot of possibilities to build proxy positions, proxy pylons with proxy gateways. So you will have the possibility to just reinforce your units pretty quickly, and it's quite difficult to find them all. So, and then with the map being so long, it's quite difficult to counterattack with Zerg. But yeah, I mean, there's some things that speak for Zerg on this map and some things for Protoss. There's also a lot of entry space for like warp prisms to warp in something where you won't be able to see it. So, we'll just see what's going to happen. We have, of course, the biggest problem for Protoss normally on this map is taking the natural base with this wide open space over here to the natural base, and this normally just comes to haunt a lot of Protoss players if the opponent really took the gold base and just outproduces you with a lot of links. I think then defending this position here can be actually quite difficult. That's why some people don't even try to just wall off everything over here, but they just try to go for a wall off from here to your nexus point, and then just defending everything else over here with units and maybe force fields if you want to go into some if you want to go into some sentries. That's normally what you can do. So we'll see what's going to happen. Wyrza just going for a very early third base. Poizon has actually scouted it, so it seems as if she just wants to pull back this little probe to a position maybe somewhere close to her opponent's bases in order maybe to punish her for her early greed by just already producing a good point close to the front where she can warp in. We're going to see how it's going to work out. Wyrza just trying to position her overlord somewhere close to the Protoss base, so she will be able to see what kind of units are being produced and when they are going to walk out. Maybe just wants to go over here to see later on whether there's a third already in position or not. So in the meantime, we just see the metabolic boost for Wyrza over here. We have the first few adepts being produced for Poizon as well, which are just going to cross the map and then do some damage. In the meantime, actually even using the photon overcharge in order to kill the first overlord over here, which can actually be kind of risky. If your opponent really went for an early attack, they might just send over some speedlings, maybe park them over here, trying to lure out the photon overcharge out of your mothership core, and then just running in knowing that you don't have another photon overcharge available. But of course in this case Poizon knows about the third base of Wyrza, knows that there are probably not a lot of links close to her own base that could just walk in. So I think the photon overcharge makes sense. It's at least one overlord less for Wyrza. She has to rebuild it. Might even be supply capped in the meantime. And there we have the proxy gateway going up, so that Poizon will be able to just warp in a lot of units at this position using the quick speed of the warp in, because there's a warp gate available. In the meantime, we have Wyrza just preparing for a big push. She hasn't scouted anything yet. She's just trying to get in with the overlord and the speed upgrade for the overlords to find out what her opponent might be up to, but it might actually be too late before she finally realizes what her opponent tries to do over here. We already have the first few adepts shaded in, so Poizon just tries to take out as many workers as possible over in the natural base. Six being taken down for three adepts, which is kinda okay, but nothing all too critical for Wryza as well. So gateway is finished, but not morphed into a warp gate yet. And now finally Wryza just gets the information where the warp gate is, so, and where the position, the proxy position for the warp ends actually is. So she might just be able to send over some links over there and just take it out, which would just buy her so much time. But it seems as if in the meantime she rather would like to either break through, because she doesn't know about the third base going down yet. So maybe she doesn't even expect it. Okay, just tries to check for the third base over here, but not at the gold base. So let's see whether she's going to check it once more. I mean, her links are just running around. She has seen the gateway over here, but she's not sending anything out to kill it. I don't know if I really like that all too much. So in the meantime, we have more gateways going down for Poizon. I think Poizon is probably very, very happy that Wryza didn't bother to check her third base at the gold, because there was not that much here to protect it. I mean, of course, there were some pylons over here, but the mothership core was quite far away, so maybe they could have been taken out before the mothership core would have arrived. There's also a few units over here as well, so she would probably not have lost it to those few links over here, but yeah, still, I mean, it might have caused some trouble. And now it's a very easy to defend position over here, because we have pylons in place, we have a photon cannon that can't even be attacked before these buildings have been taken out, so yeah, why bother? Okay, in the meantime, we've just Poizon just used the warp in point that Wryza didn't want to kill no matter what. So she just warps in a few more adepts, walks over to the third base and just kills a few more units over here. Quite nicely done by her. So again, Wryza just tries to get the big surround, but not quite possible to do so. In the meantime, the shades just walk into the natural base and then just try to get off more kills. Again, 8 workers have now already been killed. Let's have a look at the overall worker kill. It's just 15. In the meantime, we just have the production of the adept upgrade, so that they will attack a little bit faster. And Wryza just going into a spire, which is actually quite nice for her if she manages to stay alive long enough, because Poizon just actually doesn't have that much anti-air. In fact, it's only 2 Stalkers and 2 Sentries that can shoot up, plus of course photon cannons and photon overcharges. And now finally Wryza just bothers to take down that warp in point over to the right hand side, so no more quick walk-ins for Poizon using this structure. But does she already have a... She already does have a robo. She does over here, so she will be able to warp in a warp prism. Warp in a warp prism, so that she will be able to reinforce her army close to the front. So, also going into a dark shrine, after having taken the Templar Archives, which is actually quite interesting. I think the Templar Archives is not actually there for storm, it's mostly just to get rid of overgas, if you actually have some. You normally don't really want... she's going for storm, which is a bit unusual. Probably because after having seen that her opponent was going into mutas, or maybe just expecting her to go into mutas. I mean, she doesn't really has the information what her opponent was doing for sure, but of course she's seen her opponent's army mix that was mostly consisting of Lings. And if your opponent just does nothing but Lings, yeah, of course there's gas being banked up. On what is this gas being used for? Well, most of the time it's going to be mutas. So now the mutas finally arrive at Poizon's base. Mothership core is not in position, so this pylon won't help out for quite some time. Yeah, that's actually where, I mean, storm can work if your opponent is not quick enough reacting to the storm and not flying out, then actually storms can kill mutas, but they're normally not your weapon of choice, rather than just something you might want to produce because you can't get anything else in time. So yeah, storm might work against mutas, but it's actually not the best choice. So you could still go into Arcans, and Arcans can actually win you a lot of straight up engagements against muta and ling based armies. But the problem is, of course, to force the mutas into such a fight, because usually the mutas will just fly around, deal damage to wherever they go, and you just have to try to catch them and play just catch up. And you will actually just never get them. Normally you will just have to walk across your opponent's base and just try to force them into an engagement. So in the meantime, Wryza just tries to deal more damage over here to the fourth base while the mutas are still raining death from the skies inside Poizon's base. 23 probes have already died. In the meantime, we have a bigger engagement down to the right-hand side where actually Wryza is using all of her ground forces, and it seems as if Poizon actually doesn't want to play Ryza's game of trying to get the mutas. A mutas in the meantime just killing a few more important structures over here. Finally, an Archon arrives inside the main base, and now of course Wryza has to be careful. Like I said before, an Archon can actually win a big engagement against mutas, even against a lot of mutas. Not if they are too many, but still. Okay, in the meantime, we have very good upgrades for Wryza here as well, we have to say, but also quite good upgrades here for Poizon with the weapons ground level 3 almost incoming. But yeah, it's a little bit further for Wryza over here. But in the meantime, there's just one base that's getting killed while Poizon just tries to get inside maybe the third base over here. Okay, just retreats for a little bit, waits for the next warp ends, tries to gather her forces over here. And yeah, now that's actually the situation we were talking about. She's forcing her opponent into a direct engagement. We just don't know whether she will be able to win it. I mean, there's three Ultra Sphere, but it's only two, but there are also two Immortals that are just shooting away on these Ultralisks. Okay, Wryza just trying to get into a good position with her mutas, while Poizon just storms mostly her own army while trying to get the mutas with the storms. Like I said before, getting mutas with storms is a very difficult task to do, and it actually depends more on your opponent's crewing up than you actually throwing these things well enough. But I mean, 55 drones have been killed in the meantime, so Wryza not looking all too good on the economy side, but there's now nothing left that can actually kill the mutas or can even shoot up. So Wryza will finally be able to clear this up, having lost 60 workers in the meantime. Dark Templar still wrecking havoc inside the main base. Will it probably even get the upgrade here? Wow, that's actually a big hit towards Wryza, who was just trying to get the better upgrades, the better armor upgrade for her units. So the Ultras will actually not hit as hard anymore as they could normally. But yeah, I mean, Poizon just has a big problem herself. I mean, if we have a look at the income tab, of course she's looking quite okay, but she actually only has 33 workers as well. And after Wryza having just rebuilt a few of her drones, she's actually even being better in the income than Poizon, and she still has a very mobile army that can do a lot of harassment towards her opponent's units. Okay, just Poizon trying to be annoying with that DT over here, but it gets spotted and taken out. So we have the Warp Prism over here, one more Dark Templar as well, but it seems as if he's just forgotten. So in the meantime, Wryza just tries to fly around with her mutas, being as annoying as she can, while it seems as if Poizon would actually need to get more workers and a better economy up. But I think she just feels so afraid of a push that might come her way that she rather invests everything she has into army units. So Wryza just flying in, taking out more units, 13 more workers killed. And now finally it actually looks quite good for her once more, 40 against 25 workers. So again, Poizon just doesn't seem to have the right answer against the Muta play, trying to be annoying again with the Dark Templar, probably the one, yeah, that we thought was forgotten, but it wasn't. And she might even be able to take out that base over here. It depends on how fast the Overseer will be here, and just barely will be able to save it here. Quite nicely done, even getting the second Dark Templar as well. And yeah, thus far, it's actually been wasted resources by Poizon. I mean, Dark Templars are quite expensive, and she might have been better off to just try to reproduce some more units. But then again, of course, I mean, you can just actually produce more probes so that they will be taken out by this flock of mutas here, because your army will just never be fast enough in order to catch them. So yeah, it's a very frustrating situation for a lot of Protoss players. Once you actually hit that point in time where you just don't have the necessary mobile army in order to catch these mutas. So yeah, Wryza just flying from base to base. She doubles the supply of poison over here, takes out even more units and probes as she's flying around. Now getting into the main base, will maybe even be able to take out that Arctosis Pylon over here. No, just flying across an Archon that actually takes out some of these mutas. But it doesn't actually really matter. I mean, in the meantime, Wryza has just managed to get up her bases, or just saturated her bases. Again, we're at 54 to 22 workers, 2,000 mineral income to just barely 1,000 over at poison. So even doubling the income plus the better upgrades overall, it's now just 3-2 and almost 3-3. 3-3 now almost finished for Wryza over here, while it's only 3-0. Or it will only be 3-0 in quite some time for... actually, it's not researching anymore because the pylon got taken out and poison just tries to remake it as we speak. So at least the 3-0 upgrade will then continue to getting water in. Okay, I don't know if this is actually a misclick or if she really wants to have a swarm host in her army. So we have a little warp in over here. Poison just tries to buy herself more time by packing, or by just dropping units inside her opponent's base. So Dark Templar just moving around, trying to get some information of what the actual situation is. Okay, attacking the Baneling Nest actually immediately. So it seems as if Poison just wants to prepare for a big ground push, and Banelings would just prevent her from doing so. So she just wants to take out the Baneling Nest. We'll probably even get it! Wow, and there the Baneling Nest goes down, even with almost all, all of Wryza's army just being inside the main base, but a little bit too slow. Okay, can't really get the spawning pool, but yeah, I think it just doesn't even matter anymore. I mean, Wryza is just so far ahead in everything. There's really nothing that speaks for poison at the moment. I mean, she has fewer bases, she has less units, she has less worker and thus the worst income, she has worse upgrades. There's just nothing really working for her, and the mutas are still just flying around and will spot if poison just tries to take another base for herself. And even if she protects that base with most of her army, there will be another weak point in her defenses that Wryza will be able to find and abuse. Another 8 workers die, so she's down to 27 workers again. But like I said again, I mean, what can you do against this? You just have to wait until you finally mass up a big enough army that will force these mutas into a direct engagement. Or you could just try to get into Phoenixes, but that was actually just, everything just was way too late. I mean, after the first push out where Poison just tried to get into Wryza's bases, she just didn't have the resources in order to throw down the starports and then just get enough phoenixes out. And the phoenixes would actually just only help her against these mutas now, but not against all of this ground army. So okay, that's actually a nice little storm over here. The Archons are actually very well against these Lings over here, but the Ultras just chop through everything, while Poison just tries to take them down with the help of that choke point over here, but it's just not enough. Wryza just takes down everything. All of Poison's army is gone. GG, and Wryza takes the first game. Welcome to the second map of the series. We're in New Gettysburg. Spawning to the bottom left-hand side in purple is our Protoss player, Poison. And to the bottom right-hand side in green, our Zerg player, Wryza, who's leading 1-0. So let's see if she can continue her win streak. That consists of only one win, so it's not really a streak, but you don't have to tell me that. So, we have an early scout for Poison, actually. Might not be some proxy play because she's already planted down the first pylon close to her main ramp, so she will use it in order to build some buildings that will help her to wall off that region partly, so that it will be more difficult for Zerg units to just walk in. Okay, double gateway, right from the get-go, so it seems as if she wants to pressure her opponent a little bit, who's actually taken an early hatchery and not a pool first. So this actually might work out quite well, Because, as we've said before, if you are a Zerg player and you don't build your spawning pool very early on, it will take you some time in order to get it. And only with a spawning pool you will be able to get a queen. And only with a spawning pool you will be able to get Zerglings. And yeah, you will only get a lot of Zerglings if you have enough lava. And you can only get enough lava if you have a queen. So you can see the cycle and all the problems that appear, that you won't have a lot of units available once your opponent hits with an early push. And that might actually cause Wryza to lose a lot of drones. Especially if you only have slowlings, because that's another problem. If your spawning pool is late, your speed for the Zerglings will also be late. And adepts are quite fast units, and they can shade from one base to, or from one position to another. So it will be quite difficult for the Zerglings to keep up with the movement of the adepts as well. But it's all just bare theory, because right now Poizon is not really using her two gateways in order to push out. She's just producing one zealot over here and trying to fill that gap with it so that early Zerglings won't be able to just break through and tear down the whole mineral line of Poizon over here. Watch is just taking an expand over here as well. And Wryza just sees that, tries to take a hatchery of her own. And since Poizon didn't decide to use her two gateways too early on, she will actually be able to do so. So everything I was talking about theoretically just doesn't work for now, but you can just think of it for another game. Always being the educational stream. So in the meantime, we have a Twilight Council back here. So it's probably going to be DTs. It might also be the attack speed for the adepts, the resonating glaives. But yeah, I think it's probably going to be DTs. So a Dark Shrine we will probably see in just a few seconds. Okay, now going across the map with her first few adepts, trying to deal some damage. In the meantime, Wryza has managed to get out a few units. She has queens in position. She has a few Zerglings, only a few, and speed will only finish in about 20 seconds. So there might be a small timing window for Poizon to actually do some work. Yeah, she just sends the shades towards the front, trying to get some information if there are already some units over here, but there aren't. So I think she might actually just want to shade in, but she doesn't. Instead, she just stays over here, although she can't really deal damage, but she just tried to lure the units away, it seems. So just trying to get the Lings over here so that she will be able to shade away then, so that the Lings will be out of position later on. Okay, Queen kills one of the Adepts, but the other Adept is just trying to kill more workers. The unfortunate thing with a defending position, unit in position is that you actually have to micro your Adept in order to kill off any units. Oh, just unfortunate shade over here. It seems she just shaded right into the two queens and got killed immediately. But yeah, so that's the biggest problem. If there are other defending units, you will just have to actually aim for every target by hand. And that's actually quite complicated to do. Okay, so there's the Overlord, and it seems as if it wasn't the Dark Shrine as I assumed first, it's actually the Resonating Glaives. So she really wanted to get the upgrade. So in the meantime, we have a big counter attached by Wryza here, just trying to take out a few probes over here. We'll now be able to take out the other two adepts that Poizon had so far. Okay, has to get away from that photon overcharge over here, has to get away from that photon charge overcharge as well. Oh, at least getting one Overlord here as well and a few Lings. But that's actually the good thing for Wryza, since she managed to get most of the energy out of the Mothership Core. So a second follow-up push might even be more problematic to hold for Poizon, who's just trying to resaturate her base over here. In the meantime, we have Wryza just getting a lot of map vision and actually also map control with her high-speed units, so that she will actually see when her opponent tries to get everywhere. But Poizon at least has the little watchtower over here. So an Overlord in position might even be able to just gather some more information, or is just forgotten and abandoned in the meantime. So more roaches coming across for Wryza here, while the Dark Shrine is now almost finished. Yeah, I mean, it's poison. She has to build a dark shrine eventually. It's just something she has to do, or her fans just will be disappointed. So yeah, that's something you just have to do if you have a certain image. Can be quite problematic to have a certain image because people will really expect you to do something, so you just won't be able to play your favorite tactics anymore. Okay, in the meantime we have a little roach push over at the third base, so it seems as if Poizon won't be able to take the third base after all. Just has to retreat with everything, even losing the pylon she's already planted. And the longer the game goes, it actually causes a big problem for Poizon over here, because her opponent is just one base ahead. Actually, Wryza has to be careful. She doesn't want to throw away too many units over here. I mean, of course, right now she can just afford to trade off even cost inefficiently because she has the better income. So, why not just taking out as many units as she can? Finally, the Dark Templars get in and they will eventually clear up everything because there's no detection over here. So, yeah, Wryza just will lose all of her roaches, but she actually already knew that, I think, once she decided to move them inside the main base. But yeah, she just tries to do as much damage as possible and will in the meantime just send across more units. There's just one Dark Templar trying to crest and get across the bridge, but it just won't be able to do so. And more units just being rallied into the natural base of Poizon, who now finally doesn't have any more energy on the Mothership Core in order to defend this. But yeah, actually the Zealots plus the Dark Templars over here will be able to drive away these Roaches. Actually, Zealots are not that bad against Roaches if both of them are not microed, since one Zealot can actually beat one Roach in a straight-up fight. So, in the meantime, we have a Dark Templar that managed to sneak itself inside the third base of Wryza's in order to deal some damage. Only 5 drones killed, but of course it's better than nothing. Let's have a look at the drone count. Actually, it's not that bad. It's only 36 to 38. So with the early push, or not really early push, but with the repeating pushes that Wryza kept throwing towards her opponent, she's actually forgotten to produce more workers at home, and now her economical position is actually not as good as it could be and should be at the same time. So yeah, Wryza still up in supply, but I mean, like we said, she doesn't really have the income advantage. It's not as big. Poizon will now be able to finally take her third base, and I really think that Wryza should invest into her fourth base of her own, because she really wants to keep her ecological advantage here. It's actually the only thing that speaks for her. I mean, if we have a little look, she's not even gone into... Oh, well, not even, I mean it's 9 minutes, but there's not a big tech advantage for her here. She has only roaches, it's 0-0. Her opponent is now going into a robotics facility, already has the Twilight Council and the resonating upgrade upgrades. She has a Dark Shrine and thus the capability of getting Arcans. So tech-wise, she's actually looking better than her opponent. And since Wryza has just realized that she has a frick ton of money, she's just decided to build 3 hatcheries at once. And I actually like this move quite a lot, because if you have the leftover money, why the hell not use it? And just try to expand everywhere. I mean, what could happen? Some units could walk in, you just either cancel this, or if you can't anymore because it's already been built, you just lose it. But yeah, that's still not as much damage as not having another base at all. So, a few Stalkers just shoot down that Overlord over here that try to get some more scouting information, although there's nothing really interesting to scout anyways. So the game has gotten a little bit more quiet, since both players just don't really want to attack into the opponent's base. Wryza just wants to wait for her bases to get up and getting saturated, so she will probably just play a little bit more of a defensive style. Poizon has just realized that her opponent has left her alone for quite some time, so she just wants to push out a little bit, see what her opponent is doing, and see if she might be able to do some damage over at her opponent's half of the map. Wryza just investing into a hell of a lot of Zerglings here. They don't actually won't really do the trick. I mean, it's mostly Zerglings and a few Roaches. We don't have that many units that are actually good against Zerglings. We have a few Zealots over here. Do they have upgrade? No! While the Zerglings will have in just a few minutes. Stalkers are actually very, very bad against vast amount of Zerglings. So you don't really want to have them. I think Poizon just feared that her opponent would go into... Muters once more, so she rather decided to go into an army that's a little bit more capable of fending off air units, because the Stalkers even have Blink already, after researching the Resonating Glaives. And that's actually quite a nice move by Wryza over here, just trying to get across the bridge and just trying to bypass most of Poizon's army after she's just seen it taking a unit off her down up here. She now just wants to break through. Now has to be careful. I mean, she could have surrounded most of that army if she just had went out from the bridge early enough, but unfortunately she just didn't. And that's actually a good choice of her, not trying to advance this army anymore once it was too close to the narrow choke point of the bridge, because that would have been just fatal trying to fight there. So again, Wryza just trying to outrun her opponent with a fast unit. And again, I said before, I really like this move. Has to be careful not to lose too many Zerglings over here for nothing. I mean, losing like 20 or 30 links and not even killing one unit is a trade you just don't want to do, even if you're up miles and miles ahead with your economy. And actually, I think that Wryza isn't. I mean, she has 58 workers, which is okay-ish, but not actually the best amount that Zerg normally wants. So in the meantime, she just tries to get over the bridge once more, but there's the pylon in place again, and she doesn't really have the possibility to get over here and just kill it effectively. So she just retreats with the whole army composition of Roach Ravager using the bridge. But again, I mean, it's looking pretty good for Wryza. She has a lot of upgrades already, getting into Vinland Lands, getting into 2-2, getting the Ultras as well. But Poizon is going into Disruptors. So there might be a possibility to her to actually just annihilate her opponent's army if she just gets the disruptor shots right. This can just do a frick ton of damage. So let's see, Immortals are also out as well, so the Ultralisks will actually not help Wryza as much. I mean, has she seen the Ultralisk then? No, she doesn't. She probably just assumes that her opponent might be going Ultras, or she just thinks that Immortals are a good unit on the ground and just produces them anyways because they pack a punch. So, first few Disruptors are out. Poizon just moving around with her army, trying to cover as much area as possible, while Wryza also doesn't really want to move out. Zerglings just having a party with his little Ultralisk over here. Okay, or maybe it's just the old Uncle Ultralisk telling the Zerglings a little story of the war. So, and they're just listening carefully. So, in the meantime, we have another Roach Ravager army push down at the... And this is something I don't like that much. I mean, now she would have really had the possibility. Poizon is going to see that army down here, right? So she will probably move most of her army down here once it tries to enter the natural base. And then she would have been able to just do a little run-by over here with a few links. Or maybe Poizon expected that to happen. Right now her army is actually quite out of position. And again, I don't really like that movement. I mean, Wryza tried to actually run by towards the fourth base over here while hitting the natural base and the main base at the same time and actually dishing out quite some damage. 16 workers have already been killed, but now Poizon is moving in with most of her army, so she will be actually able to clean off everything that Wryza has, because the units are now stuck inside Poizon's base, and Ryza's just going to lose her whole army for not really doing that much damage. I mean, yeah, 32 workers were killed, which is actually quite a lot, but all the infrastructure of Wryza, of Poizon, is still intact, and she's actually way ahead in upgrades, way ahead in supply as well, sorry for that. So, I mean, 8 Ultras are coming out, but we still have a lot of Immortals inside the army of Poizon, so I don't really... No, never. I mean, there's Archons, there's Immortals, there's even Disruptors. Ultras just won't do shit against this army. No way in hell that Ryza's army, consisting mostly of Ultras, can kill this. I mean, it would take a huge amount of miss micro for Poizon to lose an engagement against a mostly Ultra-based army. I don't really think that can happen. I mean, good upgrades here for Wryza, we have to give her that. But it's also 2-0. I mean, it's also 2-0, but actually for an attack, the armor upgrades don't really matter as much. What really matters is that the Immortals have the hardened shields, so they will be able to just buffer a lot of damage as well. And then again, the Archons just deal a lot of damage and buffer a lot of damage as well. Poizon finally moves into the, whatever it is, 6th base location it might be, just tearing it down. In the meantime, Wryza just decides to do the best thing, tries to go for a counterattack. And it seems we could have either a base trade situation, or Poizon just decides to move back after killing off the 6th base over here. But she is probably, or maybe not, actually it seems as if the Ultras just got stuck inside, and Wryza just did the mistake of not bringing detection with her army. Oh, this is so hard to look at, especially if you are a main race Zerg player. I'm only playing random, but it still hurts my soul to see that many Ultralists getting shredded by DTs because they just can't see the poor things. It's just too awful. Okay, in the meantime, we have some Brute Lords being morphed by Wryza, so I actually think the Brute Lord tech would have been way better instead of the Ultralisks. Now she's just wasted a lot of resources into Ultralisks. Her bank is just non-existent anymore, and a few Brute Lords without any more muscle below them won't just do the trick, I feel. I mean, this is actually really problematic now. There's so many Archons in here. I mean, on the ground, there's actually nothing that Wryza can do anymore to beat this army in the next few minutes. I mean, if Poizon just retreated and let her get her army back for, like, the next 5 minutes, then maybe Wryza would have something to deal with this. But yeah, it seems as if Poizon realizes there's not too many Brute Lords in the mix, so she just decides to go for it. Well, just wanted to retreat for a second over here, but then, like I said, just realized, okay, I actually have a lot of stuff over here, I can just try to take it out. I mean, actually, these Brute Lords are dealing out a lot of damage, but it's just not going to be enough. GG, and Wryza gives it up. Poizon takes the second game and ties the series 1-1. The third map of the series, we're on King Sejong Station, spawning to the bottom right hand side in purple. As we all know, the best color for Protoss. And playing for Psystorm, it's Poizon. And to the top left hand position in green, we have Wryza, who just did the little extract trick over here. Maybe just by accident, maybe because she really wants to do it. We'll actually never figure it out. Unless, of course, we might just do the simple thing and ask her. So, seems as if Wryza wants to go for a hatch first over here, because the drone is already walking out and no spawning pool in sight, while Poizon just tries to get the early scout once more after having built the pylon at the main ramp entrance. So, Poizon just immediately gets the information what her opponent is doing. I bet she just regrets that she didn't go for a forge and just tried to cannon rush the shit out of her opponent. Might have been quite interesting. But instead, she just goes for the early expand herself, knowing that her opponent, as we said before, will have her spawning pool a lot later than normal. Oh, actually not a lot later than normal, because it's quite normal to go for a hatchery first. But yeah, she will just have her spawning pool later than it could be, and thus she won't be able to pressure her opponent in the first few minutes, which will give Poizon the time to plant down some more buildings down here, or even alongside this route. But again, a lot of players even try to just wall down something like this, because it's just less space you need to cover. But she will have the time in order to do so. So in the meantime, Poizon just walking out across the map, searching for, well, not really a proxy position, but we can call it a hidden position, where she will be able to throw down a pylon and then some hidden tech. It might be a Stargate tech, trying to go for oracles, which is a bit uncommon for her. We haven't seen her playing a Stargate opening very often. So I'd rather think it might be DTs once more, but we'll see. I mean, it's also a bit far away for a Stargate, but yeah. I mean, sometimes you just don't want to get spotted at all, and you don't even want to take risks. So that's why you try to get somewhere close. Wryza just being supply blocked like crazy in the meantime. which is a bit unfortunate for her, but in the meantime she's taking a Baneling Nest and even getting the Metabolic Boost upgrade, the Zergling Speed, as we also used to call it. So, in the meantime we have the Overlord getting inside the main base, another Zealot being produced, no Warlord has started yet. And there's also no pylon down here, so even with a Mothership Core it might be a bit problematic. And there's the Stargate, as I was talking about. I mean, sometimes the first instinct is just the best thing to listen to. So, we have some Zerglings inside the natural base, even a few probes are already dying, something that actually shouldn't really happen to Poizon at that point in time. With some micro, it should be possible to just save all of them, but now actually three probes have already died, maybe even a fourth one. Finally, the Mothership Core comes down and will be able to help out, raining some fire from the sky. And there's also another Adept here, so together with the Zealot, well, it seems as if Wryza just wants to do some more attacking, can't really get up the ramp because there's a Zealot still in place, but you might be able to take out everything that's down here, not even getting the Zealot here, this is really bad for her, and now with the Banelings in here, I mean, if she managed to get a good hit with the Banelings, but there's only two probes over here, throwing the Banelings into the units is something you actually don't want to do. And again, it seems as if Wryza just wants to go for a very hard attack. In the meantime, Poizon just tries to get her first Oracle out and will apply some counter pressure once it arrives at the enemy's base, while Wryza is just going for more and more Lings, trying to use their momentary advantage like crazy. And now finally Poizon manages to seal off most of her... It almost seems as if there was a space, but there shouldn't be. So in the meantime, we have the Oracle inside Ryza's base. Not too much has been lost so far. Two drones, four drones. That's almost it. Getting a fifth one as well, so quite nicely done over here. Getting a sixth one. It has to be careful not to lose it, and there it goes down. Unfortunately for her, while Wryza has tried to take her third base as well. But yeah, if we have a look at the worker count, I mean, it's more workers for Poizon at the moment, and that's just a position you never want to be in. I mean, the only thing, again, that speaks for Wryza at the moment is the third base going up, while Poizon is still setting on two bases, and the second one is not even that that saturated, because she just had to spend a lot of resources to build units to fend off that Ling push and also constructing a few gateways. But yeah, it's okay. If you see that, it looks as if you wouldn't be able to walk between those gateways, but you actually can, as this setup here proves. So yeah, she also had to clear this off. So, I think these Zerglings are just around here in order to take down a third base if it had already been taken. Maybe she wants to make something happen once the units move out, but she doesn't actually have a lot of units in position, or maybe even overlords, in order to check for this. So, this time around, Poizon uses her Stargate quite nicely in order to produce some more Phoenixes. So I think going into Mutas really isn't an option for Wryza here. I mean, she's behind, or was actually behind anyways, with all of her early aggression and everything, not having that many workers. But in the meantime, she's just managed to get up more workers and will now have finally an income that's worthy of a Zerg player in the meantime. So there's the first push of Poizon, and actually there's not many units out here, so since Wryza just tried to get up her economy, she had to take the risk a little bit, hoping that her opponent wouldn't attack her right away, because she probably knew that she was quite far behind in workers and everything. So it seems as if she just wanted to take the risk and is now paying dearly for it. 13 workers have already died. The rest of the links that were actually positioned down here now finally come back in, and they will probably barely be enough in order to hold everything off. In the meantime, the Phoenixes are at the third base trying to take out more drones using the Graviton Beam, lifting all the drones and then just killing them. And as we can see, the few Lings around here weren't even enough to kill off at least one of the Adepts, and the Adepts are still doing damage like crazy, now finally shading into the main base, doing even some more damage. 15 workers and have already been killed, and until the Adepts are going to die, more units will have to suffer. So this is actually not really looking good at all. And actually, Poizon just saw the spire going down. And as we were talking before, with so many phoenixes out already, and where are they actually? Where are the phoenixes? Phoenixes! Okay, let's have a look at the units tab. There's one. And there are the others. Okay, right over here. So with that many phoenixes out already, I think the spire won't really prove valuable at all in the meantime. Maybe later on in the game, maybe if Wryza just manages to save enough resources to like produce 20 something mutas at once, while Poizon is not really expecting that to happen. So I think that might actually work out quite well if Wryza just moved in immediately. But yeah, Poizon has just realized what's going to happen. Warps in some zealots as well, so this push has been defended quite easily. Nothing here that Wryza can actually do. And like we said before, I mean, Ryza's down in workers not as much anymore, since she's already tried to replenish most of her drones. Still, I don't really see what she can do. I mean, her supply is down to 59. She's even in the big supply block. Poizon's supply is just rising. They are both on the same amount of bases, and this is actually almost telling the story. I mean, yes, a Zerg can beat a three-base Protoss with like two bases or the same amount of bases if the Zerg is preparing for a hard push. That is well timed, but I mean that time is actually over. Wryza is just trying to stay alive somehow, crossing fingers that something might happen that could save her that game. But Poizon just won't have it. She's already out again and tries to take down that third base over here. Has not spotted the fourth base yet. Maybe now with the phoenixes? No, just barely not. But again, don't think it's really going to matter. Okay, nicely a new hallucinated Arcans and Disruptors over here, which is actually quite nice. So if her Poizon doesn't bring detection with her, a lot of army units will actually try to attack these hallucinations first, because they pose the bigger threat. And in the meantime, again, Poizon just taking out every drone that Wryza built over the last few minutes. So she just can't get back into the game with that small amount of drones and economy. I mean, even that base over here won't help her at all with all the drones having died already. So, oh, even nice going for preparing a little point of return here. A point of defense where if the units just try to follow her into that stasis ward, she could just lure them into it. So in the meantime, just trying to take down more of the lava down here, it seems. Don't really know why she's not attacking into the natural base. I think she could easily do that, or could have easily done that over the last few seconds, and might have even killed off the reinforcements before they had the chance to gather together. But yeah, there it worked out. She just lured a lot of units into the stasis ward, and can now take out everything else, while the Hydras just can't do jack shit against it. The rest of the army moves in, kills everything off. Wryza realizes it's GG, and Poizon takes the third game for 2-1. It's the fourth map of the series. We're on Frozen Temple, spawning to the top left-hand side in purple. Is our Protoss player Poizon leading 2-1? And in the bottom right-hand corner in green, we have our Zerg player Wryza, who, I don't really have to say it, but I will do it anyways, because that's what I'm not getting paid for. She has to win two games in a row, or she will have lost that series with that game. Which, of course, puts a lot of pressure on you, if you, of course, are a competitive person and take this stuff very seriously. Otherwise, you might still feel a little bit relaxed. Of course, there's a little tension. You don't really want to lose. But yeah, if you're like a person like Devil May Care, then it may not even cause you that much stress. But maybe it does. So we'll see. Wryza again just going for a hatch first, which is actually a bit risky on that map. I've talked about that one again and again. Because the rush distances from one main, from one natural base to the other natural base are quite short. So units can actually cross the map quite easily. And there's also a lot of possibilities to hide proxy buildings. And especially on that on that map, a lot of Protoss players in the FSL like to do a four-gate push, like at that position over here, or maybe at that position over here, or maybe even sometimes down here, but mostly coming from that angle. So we've actually seen, I think, two or three Protosses in the FSL doing the four-gate push from one angle or the other. And then, of course, hatchery first is just deadly. It's almost a build order win. I mean, there are possibilities to hold it, but only if your micro is just godlike and your opponent is screwing up. So that's really difficult to hold normally. Okay, but in this case, we don't have the problem. Poizon just went for an early base herself, trying to wall off at her main ramp. That's actually quite interesting, I think. I mean, if you plan to go for an early base anyways, why not try to wall off down here right from the get-go? I mean, I think it would be better. I mean, yeah, this might be safer if your opponent really went for a 12 pool or a 13 pool. You will be able to defend it a little bit more easily from with that setup, but I don't know. I mean, if you really think you will get through with this base down here unprotected, without a pylon, without any buildings, nothing. So I think you might as well just build your first buildings down here anyways. So Poizon just going for another Stargate hidden, and actually this time even it's proxied, we can say, because it's pretty close to the base at some point. Overlord seems to take the right direction, but it just will reach this part of the map so late. At least it might be able to tip Wryza off once the Oracle pops out and flies towards the main base, because that's probably where it's going to be headed. It's the most logical thing to do. Oh, actually just Wryza has her timings down. Probably doesn't really know what her opponent is up to, but she just assumes that her opponent might be able to do a Stargate push. I mean, she hasn't scouted anything, she doesn't really know what her opponent does, so she has to prepare for every eventuality. And thus, she just throws down a Spore Crawler in every base that will help her defend. Not this one, so maybe the Oracle will still be able to do some damage. Otherwise, one Oracle alone won't do it. But she's not really going for an Oracle. It's actually Phoenixes, so never mind. So she just wants to go in. And actually, the Phoenixes will be able to do some damage, because even with a Spore Crawler in position, you can just fly in, pick off two drones, and fly out. Of course, it will take some shields off of your Phoenixes, maybe even some armor, but it just won't kill them. And sometimes, if like the gas is over here, you will even be able to pick off some drones that are mining gas without even getting into the range of the Spore Crawler. So there's always possibilities of doing damage if you go Phoenixes. But Phoenixes are a little bit more difficult to play, since they want a lot of micro from you. They need a lot of micro in order to be really effective and worth their investment. So, it's not what everybody wants to play, because you have to use them on the map very efficiently in order to make the investment valuable. So let's see how it's going to work. Wryza actually just being greedy as hell, going for fourth base down at the southern location. So, okay, let's see how this is going to work. She still doesn't really know what her opponent is up to, does she? I mean, she managed to get inside the main base, hasn't really seen a lot, has seen the Twilight Council, will probably even see it once more and see it researching. The big problem right now is, of course, that you actually don't know what the Twilight Council is researching, because there are now more upgrades for ground units. I mean, if you see a lot of Stalkers, you can of course assume that it's going to be Blink. But if you see just a lot of ground units, maybe a mix of Zealots and Adepts, how would you know that this is leg speed or the attack speed for the Adepts? There's actually no chance to really know it. I mean, of course, if she flew back and saw these Zealots over here, she would of course be tipped. She would of course be tipped off that this is going to be the Zealot leg speed. But now she doesn't really know. Maybe she expected. Maybe she doesn't. Maybe she doesn't care at all. We can't really know. So Oracle also in production. So. Actually, it seems as Poizon has just pooled a lot of air units over to the left-hand flank and will now fly in any minute, and even having some Zealots to support her. So it seems as if she really wants to go for, well, not a full-out attack although she's also moving a few more units over here as well. It seems more like a multi-prong harassment where she tries to get her opponent to move over here in order to pull her out of position and then just walk in with the rest of the units, maybe into the third base, and trying to kill off more units over there. Thus far, it works out quite nicely. She's already just tore down a lot of drones over here, and Wryza is not really doing anything against it. It seems as if she just doesn't have enough anti-air at all. The Phoenix is just picking off drones after drones, now going for the queens, taking out another queen over here as well. Well, now maybe retreat, but it's still enough Phoenixes in order to pick off the last queen as well. And now there's actually no anti-air at all. In the meantime, the Zealots just enter the third base of Wryza, and again, there's just nothing here. Wryza just played the most greedy game I've ever seen, not having any units in order to defend, not on the ground, not in the air. It seems as if she just wanted to wait for that spire to happen and then just produce 40 mutas at once or whatever. Now finally investing some resources into speedlings, but it's probably just going to be way too late. The third base, or the fourth base, has gone down. The third base just has been ripped apart. All the work has just gone down as well. Now finally moving in, killing off the rest of Ryza's army, and again there's just nothing left. And now finally she's just spent all of her larva. The only thing she can produce are a few hydralisks that won't actually even help against these units. I mean, Poizon will actually almost be able to lift all of her hydras. Not all of them, but most of them, so they won't even be able to deal damage while the Zealots just tear apart everything that's on the ground. More drones have to die. Zealots just taking apart everything that's there. More Zealots coming in. In the meantime, Poizon takes a third base, but I think it just probably won't even matter. She will probably not even have to use it at all. Okay, we don't want to be too quick. I mean, there's no more reinforcements headed her way. She really invested a lot of resources into expanding. Has to be careful not to lose to Phoenixes, though. Okay, just retreats for now. But yeah, the damage has already been dealt. Now again, just moving in with the Zealots and the Phoenixes. Like I said before, just trying to lift everything up so that the Zealots can do their dirty work towards the ground units. Okay, just dealing more and more damage, and at that point it's actually the way around that a Zerg player normally would like to be. That, the Protoss player can actually just waste a few units over here. Nice micro, just running circles, trying to get the Zealot AI freak out a little bit. I mean, the only thing that really speaks for Wryza right now is that she still has that third base up, so she might be able to replenish all of her drones here. If not in an instant, then quite easily, while Poizon just tries to saturate her own third over here. But, I mean, the next push is already being prepared. We have a lot of Archons over here as well. Fortunately for Wryza, she's actually going to see what's going to come her way in just a few minutes. Or maybe even just a few seconds, it depends. No, probably a few minutes. Poizon just being active with her Phoenixes. I like this a lot, just taking out another Overlord over here. These Phoenixes have done so much damage already, not even killing that much, but still just providing so much support with everything. And now just Poizon moves across again with the Archons and the Zealots. And again, this army actually looks a bit more capable of stopping what's headed the way. She would have to micro it a lot, actually, in order to make it work against the Speedlots and the Archons. But yeah, I think this base, if a Poizon really commits, is going to die. Ooh, Wryza actually cancels it before Poizon has the chance to decide whether she wants to fight the army or the base. So, retreats for a little bit, has to be careful from Mothership Core. Mothership Core just here in order she has to retreat and just throw down a recall here. So, but it seems, again, as if Wryza just doesn't have enough. I mean, the Zealots just press everything backwards. The Archons can just dish out the damage from behind. Phoenixes just lifting up everything that could endanger the Phoenixes. And now the third base finally goes down, and this is the final nail in the coffin. There's nothing that Wryza can do from that point on. Being on two bases that are almost mined out with more units walking in? No. Just no. I'm sorry, fans of Wryza. I don't really want to spoil that game for you, but you should also know it. It's over. These links won't just do nothing against Archons. Archons just kill Zerglings like crazy. Haven't you watched the intro to Legacy of the Void? I mean, there you can just see what happens if a Zergling attacks an Archon. 34 workers have died. Everything is going down. Maybe the Mothership Core. It will be the last victory of Wryza, but being down to 40 supply, it's only a third of what Poizon has. Don't really know what Wryza is waiting for. Expect GG any minute. I mean, she's really the never give up, never surrender sword, trying to defend her pride until the very last unit, but it's just for naught. I mean, there's not much that can happen. Poizon takes the series with a 3-1.